Welcome back to the channel. My name's Fonz. I'm a maker of things. Some might know me as a graphic designer. Some might know me as a rapper first, musician, whatever. I like making shit. That's what I do. Appreciate y'all for checking out this video. But let's get into why I returned the Brother Skitch PP1. So, pretty much if your goal is to primarily embroider on felt and do iron-on patches, then the Brother Skitch PP1 is perfect for you. They don't really get into that when they promote the product much. While it is on the box in the store, and you see a lot of people in videos doing patches that are actually like really great. There's some dope videos out there. Nobody really says that it isn't for anything outside of patches. So people like myself who are familiar with embroidery, but wanted something kind of low entry to get in, you know, get their foot in the door with it. You know, people like myself thought, you know, that's a great idea. Well, I tried that. Didn't really work out. The Brother Skitch PP1 did not like hoodies. All right. It destroyed a hoodie. It destroyed a bobbin. If you're unfamiliar with what a bobbin is, you can Google it. But a bobbin is one of these joints right here. And what a bobbin does is it feeds in a loop like this. The needle comes down and it pretty much puts a thread, the same color thread normally, through the loop, and it pulls it up through the garment or fabric or whatever you're embroidering. And that's how it pretty much like kind of seals like the stitch and kind of makes that really kind of thick, you know, embroider look and feel. Not a big deal. These things right here, like, you know, you can get a pack of fucking 10 of them for like, you know, pennies on the dollar. So it's really not a big deal, but it's the principle of it. Pretty much like, you know, the Brother Skitch PP1 was constantly, it bent every single needle that came with the embroidery machine, right? Excuse me. It destroyed every single needle. When I say destroyed every single needle, there was one that bent and flew across my table like a fucking projectile, right? That's super dangerous. Not sure if you know what a sewing needle looks like, but they're pretty sharp. And when they break, they're pretty sharp. And so I was like, all right, that's kind of weird. Embroidered, you know, put another needle in, kind of worked with it for a little bit. They didn't bend right away, but they would bend if they came across some problems, right? So I was embroidering a hoodie. And the hoodie design was pretty simple. It was just like a quick little typeface because I was like trying to test it out, right? And I felt kind of confident after embroidering on a t-shirt, where this time, you know, I did use the fabric stabilizer. Originally, when I bent the first needle, I didn't use any fabric stabilizer. But I figured, I figured it was user error when that happened. Turns out it was not user error when that happened. Pretty much, use fabric stabilizer on a hoodie. It was on there pretty taut, so you kind of like, you know, hit it and hear like the little drum sound. I'll kind of show you guys what that looks like in another video, for anybody that's looking to get the Brother Skitch PP1 and just kind of wanting to get familiar with the world of embroidery. But pretty much, yeah, the machine did this thing where even though it was pretty taut, because like the embroidery machine, it uses, unlike this right here, right? This is the embroidery hoop. I'm like showing it up close like you guys can see it. So this is the embroidery hoop for the the PE900, right? The Brother Skitch PP1 has a magnetic hoop that clamps the fabric around the frame, right? This is more of a screw style thing, right? It's a lot more reliable because it like physically clamps it in there. The Brother Skitch does not do that. So I guess sometimes there's some shifting or whatever when you're embroidering or while the machine's embroidering, because it's completely AI controlled and everything, or robotically controlled, whatever you want to call it. And there was some bunching of the fabric. And so when the fabric bunches up, right? This little receipt. Let's say it's flat like this and the needle's going through it. As soon as it does this, that fabric starts to bunch together and then it jams itself within the machine. And then the bobbin gets all destroyed. The needle breaks, you know, and that's what made this machine suck, right? And I say this machine sucks, and I don't think it's anything that anybody should buy, because it happened to me within, within a day, right? Within, you know, days apart. Each use, I broke a needle somehow, even after having all the right supplies. And overall, I'm pretty sure it's just a really cheap machine. And that's just my honest opinion. I guess some of the other problems outside of like those two or three main ones is the machine is user friendly, but it's super cheaply made. Let me go back. I guess one of the other big problems with the two is outside of like the physical things breaking on it and messing up and jamming, the thread constantly comes undone and you constantly have to redo it. Now, when I tell you this machine is super easy to thread, you follow the guides along the machine. They're numbered one by one. You get really fast at doing it. You pull the lever and the machine actually has a mechanism that feeds the thread through the needle for you, right? So it's like it's really easy to work with. But for whatever reason, the thing just keeps coming unthreaded. And, you know, I'm not a fucking idiot. You know, I'm like looking at the thing, I'm watching it, I'm like, the only reason this thing could come undone is if it was cheaply made. And the only way I could know if it was cheaply made was to go get a new sewing machine. Now, it was a gamble, right? It's like, all right, cool, you already spent a little bit of money. But I'm thinking, well, if I can just return this thing and get store credit at Joann Fabric, then I can go in and I can get a new embroidery machine and I can prove to myself that it wasn't user error. And turns out I was right. So I guess to say a couple things that are good about the Brother Skitch. If you care about aesthetics, I really love the fact that it was like a gray embroidery machine. That was really dope. It looked great in my jeez. It looked great in my setup, right? I felt like it was a conversation piece. It was dope to talk about. I was excited to talk about it on my channel. I felt like it didn't have these weird floral patterns on it and it wasn't light blue. It didn't look like, it just didn't look corny, right? But it is what it is, right? It looked like an espresso machine. I really like that. But, you know, we all, you know, beggars can't be choosers. So, you know, I went ahead and swapped it out for that PE900. And now I have the PE900. And to be honest, the PE900 is a really dope machine so far. I don't like the color, but it's super powerful. Out the box, I was able to set this thing up in probably 15 minutes, 15 to 20 minutes, because you obviously got to like register it in like the Art Spira app, just like the Brother Skitch. And pretty much I had this thing up and running and was able to embroider something perfectly fine. It's kind of messed up on here a little bit, but as you can see, you know, hopefully, yeah. As you can see, I was able to embroider that out the box. So that should tell you everything that you need to know, that the PE900 is a great investment. Now, if you're watching this and you're waiting on somebody dope to kind of really get into embroidering on the Brother Skitch PP1, you're still in luck, because while I'm not a tried and true embroiderist, nor will I ever be, possibly. I don't know. I just make shit. I can still guide you using some of the same principles that I kind of learned with setting up the Brother Skitch PP1 that I can utilize on the PE900. Because they're both from the same company, I can still probably troubleshoot the same problems. And we're just going to go on this journey together. I will say, I have started working on some things with it. Like I just showed you on the felt over there that I was like kind of messing with some, you know, some typefaces and whatnot. This hat right here was like an old hat that I had where I spelled failure wrong on it. I decided to put a F on here, you know, for failure, and do some kind of fly with it. And, you know, we just gonna go on this journey and kind of figure out how to do this embroidery thing. Out the box, I'm like pretty decent already. I'm not gonna hold you, but it's gonna be a long, fun journey. And like I said, this machine isn't cheap, but it's worth it. And yeah, if y'all have any questions on the world of embroidery and you really want to get into it and you want to know, or you, if you want me to make any type of videos or explore any problems that you have or troubleshoot anything that you have, let me know. Yeah, because that's where I'm at with it. I'll be dropping a Brother Skitch PP1 video. It was one of the final videos that I filmed with the Brother Skitch. It'll be kind of like the part two to this, I guess. And I think that'll be very insightful, so you can kind of see the problems that I was having with the machine, like the constant stop and go. It wasn't really... Overall, that machine is not worth the money. I feel like it was something that they rushed out to market. It's cheaply made. It's the idea behind it is great. Like, a lot of people want to say that that it wasn't really well thought out. I noticed that a lot of people that own the machine are having a hard time kind of working around the idea of like the Bluetooth, right? And the Bluetooth is really easy. If it doesn't connect, you actually just delete it from your internal phone's Bluetooth list. Like, it's like you forget it as a device, and then it'll actually delete itself in the Artspira app, and then you just add it back. So those aren't the real problems that you're going to have with this embroidery machine. The real problem that you're going to have with this embroidery machine is the fact that it sucks and it's poorly made on a mechanical level. It's just ass. And there's no way to put it other than that. So yeah, that's where we're at with it. But anyway, my name's Fonz. Welcome to the channel. If you're new here, subscribe, leave a comment, hit the like button, hit the notification bell. We're going to be getting into the PE900 shortly here. And I'll be releasing products. If you want to join my mailing list, go ahead and subscribe to my Substack below. I'll be doing drops there pretty soon. That's pretty much an exclusive place to kind of, you know, get any content that I'm dropping here. And we're gonna do some dope stuff and do some dope vlogs. I can't wait to kind of just have fun with this shit. Yeah, peace. I appreciate y'all. Till next time.